agencies don't have their models' best interests at heart because if they did, they probably wouldn't make as much money.
I'm a model.
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 The model apartment that I lived in was like the biggest ripoff ever.
You had a two-bedroom, two bathrooms with fucking seven people there. Every girl was paying $1,200, and that's seven people. So $1,200 times seven, that's a pretty good chunk of change. I mean, we could afford another bedroom in there. Come on now.
There's nothing really comfortable about the job. Multiple people are touching your face and your body all day long. I remember the Fendi show that I walked in. The hair look for that season, I believe, was some sort of braid, almost like a cornrow. Like, tears were streaming down my face because for like 2 hours he was trying to braid my hair. And then my agent was like, oh yeah, you shouldn't have cried.
When a photographer comes up to you and moves you around like you're a mannequin, picks up your arm and positions it, moves your chin, I find that incredibly insulting. Especially if you're nude. Just don't touch me.
I think a lot of male photographers ascend in their careers because they are charming or good looking. And so, like, enduring conversation with them often is uncomfortable because there's a level of flirtation, but also sort of like diminishment. It became extremely challenging to be in these environments where you're supposed to be accommodating, placating, pleasing to idiots who are just chipping away at anything that you might value about yourself beyond like what you look like.
I was just naturally always sexy, if that makes sense. So I think I would be put into these shoots that were sexier. One of my older friends took me to the set and the photographer tried to put me in these like little tiny bathing suits and was like, it's okay if things fall out. And I'm like, no, I'm 13. This is not okay.
I was a kid, so I felt very submissive to all of these people who I equated as authority figures. If I was told to do something, I did it. I wanted to do a good job at this crazy opportunity that I was presented with.
I was shooting catalog, and one day there was a new girl that came in, and she was shooting, and I was trying to get to know her. And so at lunch we were chatting. She had asked me a question. She said, "My agency asked me if I would be willing to go on a date or to go out with this guy, and they were willing to pay me. I think it was $2,500 or $3,000. I don't remember what it was." She's like, do you do those types of things? Like, if your agency asks you, is that something you should do? Like, I don't want them to be upset with me." I remember her just being so lost and just not knowing what to make of the whole situation.
If girls kind of get trapped in a cycle of debt to their agency, or they get, you know, pushed into prostitution, which happens, it can be really rough, you know? There's a lot of, like, young girls that end up that way.
A photographer that I really wanted to work with, he was doing a series of nudes for a book. The team was there, the hair, makeup, closed set. And then at one point, I think he came over to kind of rearrange my hair or something, and he tried to kiss me. And I pushed him off, and I said, "What are you doing? This is not okay with me." And of course, my heart is racing, and I'm thinking, I gotta get out of there. And I did. I grabbed the robe, put it on, walked off, got my clothes on. You can't help but think, did I do something to perpetuate this? Did I do something for him to think that it was okay?
It was in the beginning of my career, and this famous photographer was shooting a series of photos for his upcoming exhibition, and my agent thought it would be good to get in with him. I went to his apartment, and in the beginning, it was actually totally fine. The pictures looked amazing. However, at some point he asked me if it was okay if we'd moved to the bedroom, which, still being naive, I didn't think too much of, until he was on top of me with a camera and his hand stroked my breast. And all of a sudden it dawned on me that I kind of had to get away. I made up some silly excuse that I had castings afterwards and kind of half ran out. Then after that he put me on a 3-day shooting, overnighting at Shelter Island. And it was a big job, so I could not say no. And He would just, like, give me a different call time than the rest of the crew. And when I would show up, it was only him alone in the room, and it was like dodging bullets, like, for 3 days in a row. Of course, I told my agent about what happened, and they told me, yeah, he's known to do that with girls.
If you don't have the right people around you, you could easily end up on a yacht with some rich guy doing loads of drugs and fall off and die, or get an eating disorder, or, you know, just fall into the wrong hands. I don't believe in young girls getting signed or blown up that quickly. I don't think it's fair, because it takes away a part of your innocence, you know, like something that you can never get back. I had on training wheels, you know, so now that I had my moment, I'm actually ready to run. And I wouldn't have had it any other way.